If you ask me which streaming software to use 2 years ago, I'll definitely gonna tell you Streamlabs. Streamlabs is the easiest to set up for you to go live or even doing your recording gameplays and also for content creations. But things started to change differently until I tested OBS Studio. Whether you are a beginner streamer or starting as a small content creation, this video is for you. I'm gonna share my experience because I have tested both the software so that you don't have to. And after this video, I hope that you're able to find out which is best for you. And for you to understand it more easily, I'm gonna break it into 4 main factors, who should use it and why. And the last factor is the most important factor that makes me wanna stick with OBS. So be sure to watch to the last. Before diving into the factors, what is Streamlabs and OBS? It is basically a broadcast software that used for live streamings and recordings. Both produce the same function but aims different focus and features. So which we are gonna talk about, the first factors. Let's start the first factor, which is very important, especially for beginners. That is ease of use or UI. So just by looking at these two UI, drop me a comment below on which one that looks easier for you. 1 or 2. I remember the first time that when I looked at both software, I was like, oh, OBS just looks so complicated to me. So I make my decisions to actually start streaming and start my content creating using Streamlabs. So I basically recommend Streamlabs for beginners who especially wanted just to start streaming or even content creating or maybe recording your gameplay moments. Because Streamlabs, by looking at it, it just looks so easy to use. All you need is just add some source, which is your audio, your mic, your game capture or maybe display capture and webcam if you are using a webcam, and some of the settings you will need in order for it to go live. OBS Studio, on the other hand, it just gave you blank, like totally empty. It does not actually have those built-in tools or features like how Streamlabs does. You'll have to search for it. I mean, you have to actually do the customization for yourself. It's probably gonna take you hours to actually just looking at it. So which is really, really time consuming. So the features we mentioned earlier, which bring us to factors number 2. That is the built-in tools and features. So basically Streamlabs has almost everything you need as a beginner streamers or even a small creator. We're talking about something like integrated chat. I mean the chat box, alert box, donation widgets, and you can even test the alert widgets inside Streamlabs itself. But on the other hand, when it comes to OBS, you'll have to figure it out how to make those things work, most of it all by yourself. And it gonna take a lot of times. So as a beginner, I actually suggest that you go for Streamlabs, because trust me, you won't want to waste a lot of time just to figuring out how to use OBS. Instead that you can just go for Streamlabs and start your stream as quick as possible. But if it's so hard to use, why is OBS so famous? What makes it so famous? And here comes the factors number 3. Customizations and plugins. Streamlabs, when it comes to plugins, is not really that much choice. For example, that I'm actually using Nvidia Broadcast for my webcam blur, and I use it in Streamlabs, it's sometimes unable to use, it crashes also. So when it comes to plugin and customization, there is not too much stuff that you can actually add in Streamlabs. But when it comes to OBS, oh, when it comes to plugin and customization, OBS is the king right here. You can add so much stuff, for example, that the mask of your webcam, or you wanna make your webcam very fancy, or even change color with your audio, or maybe some scene transitions. There's so much more, you just name it. But if you love to tweak and optimize your OBS, you might be able to include a lot of plugins. But the more plugins you have in your OBS, the more resource power that your PC have to actually handle. So even if you're starting up with OBS, I actually suggest that you start up with clean, with just a normal scene transitions, and stream with both Streamlabs and OBS to test out, to check it, how the performance work. And here comes when we talk about performance, which actually bring us to the most important factors that actually makes me want to stick with OBS, even for my streamings or content creating. That is factors number 4, CPU usage and the stability of the performance. Even though Streamlabs is easy to use, or even look friendly to me, but When you are gaming and streaming with Streamlabs at the same time, it is because that they got all-in-one package or all-in-one of those cool features built-in tools for new streamers, and it gonna take more CPU powers for about maybe about 5 to 15% extra, which actually a lot of difference compared to those CPU that has lesser cores and threads. OBS Studio, on the other hand, it provides more efficiency, provides better performance, and of course, better stability on mid-end and low-end PC systems. But it also very good for a single PC streamer like I do. It's because when you're streaming and gaming at the same time, your FPS will drop a lot if you do not have a smooth gaming, and so goes to your stream. And we do not want that happen. So OBS will be a good choice if that you have a mid-end system, because it takes less CPU usage and able to actually give you a better gaming experience whenever you are doing your gaming and also together with your streaming. So when it comes to stability, CPU usage and performance, OBS is definitely the winner here. So OBS Studio is trusted by pros for a reason. It's open source, rarely crashes, updates are stable, and that's a plugin for almost everything. On the other hand, Streamlabs actually has improved over time, but it still deals with unstable bugs, especially when you're using third-party plugins. So after all the comparison, Streamlabs is easier to use, great for beginners, it comes with a lot of built-in features and tools that you'll need as a streamer, but it uses more CPU powers. On the other hand, OBS Studio provides more stable, customizable, better performance when it comes to streaming and gaming at the same time if you want a full control of the software. The right choice depends on your priority, either convenience or full control. Are you starting with Streamlabs or OBS? Drop me the comment below and share your experience. Alright, so I hope this video helps you to figure out which is best for you. And do not forget to give this video a big like and subscribe to my channel if you're new to here. And you might want to check this playlist. It actually talks about how to set up your mic, your audio, even your game capture, your streaming settings, or even your recording setting for Streamlabs. Alright, thanks for watching. I'll see y'all in the next video. Peace.